Hey guys, welcome to Skills Course for Law Students. Hope everyone is doing well. So guys, I'm going to be doing the MCQ for SCL 1501 revision. So let's begin with question number one. Question number one. Indicate the correct statement. The Skills Course for Law Students SCL 1501 deals with number one, the importance of skills in our studies and legal profession. Number two, effective learning and banking education. Number three, tasks or activities as more important than knowledge. Number four, integration of knowledge, theory, and cases. So guys, here the correct answer is number one, which says the importance of skills in our studies and legal profession. So guys, let me highlight the answer for you. Question two. Consider the following statements before choosing the option. A. Law is the body of rules that governs only criminals in the society. B. When the law is described as a system of norms, it is known as a private law. So choose your answer from the one of the following. Number one, statement A and B are correct. Number two, statement A and B are incorrect. Number three, statement A is correct, statement B is incorrect. Number four, statement A is incorrect, statement B is correct. So guys, here the correct answer is option number two, which says statement A and B are incorrect. Question number three, indicate the correct statement. The following holds true for meaningful education. Number one, no relation exists between studying and learning. Number two, it is correct for students to easily confuse studying and learning. Number three, dialogue is essential for learning. Number four, learning is a core element of banking education. So guys, here the correct answer is number three, which says dialogue is essential for learning. Question number four. Indicate the correct statement. The following aspects appropriately describe banking education. Number one, Paulo Freire promotes banking education because it appropriates reasoning capacity. Number two, questioning or interrogating of information enhances banking education. Number three, banking education gives a balance between studying and learning. Number four, banking education undermines the notion of practice. So guys, here the correct answer is number four, which says banking education undermines the notion of practice. Question five. Indicate the incorrect statement. All of the following are suggestions for improving your listening skills, except number one, sympathizing with the speaker. Number two, paraphrase the speaker. Number three, empathizing with the speaker. Number four, maintain eye contact with the speaker. So guys, here the correct answer is number one, which is sympathizing with the speaker. Question number six. Indicate the correct statement. The reason why nonverbal communication is important is because number one, 35% of one's messages is communicated verbally. Number two, 65% of the message is transmitted through it. Number three, influence and perception are at the center of legal practice. Number four, a magistrate or judge accepts nonverbal messages. So guys, here the correct answer is number two, which says 65% of the messages is transmitted through it. Question number seven. Indicate the correct statement. The following hold true for examination issue. Number one, no leading questions are allowed. Number two, all leading questions are allowed. Number three, the lawyer asks his or her own witness questions. Number four, the lawyer punches holes in the witness testimony? So guys, here the correct answer is number 1, which says no leading questions are allowed. Question number 8. Indicate the statement. When does an Act of Parliament come into force? Number 1, after it has been signed by the President. Number 2, immediately after it has been passed by the Parliament. Number 3, after it has been signed by the President and published in the Government Gazette. Number 4, after it has been passed by Parliament and signed by the President. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says after it has been signed by the President and published in the Government Gazette. Question 9. Indicate the correct statement. Which one is regarded as a presumption when reading or interpreting legislation? Number 1. Legislation is presumed to contain meaningless sections. Number 2. Legislation is presumed to intend to achieve reasonable and justifiable consequences. Number 3. Legislation is presumed to change existing law, particularly common law. Number 4, legislation is presumed to apply retrospectively. So guys, here the correct answer is number 2, which says legislation is presumed to intend to achieve reasonable and justifiable consequences. Question 10. Indicate the incorrect statement. The procedure in action proceedings is stated by way of summons. Number 2. Action proceeding is used when there are no fundamental disputes on the facts of the case between the parties involved. Number 3. The parties in action proceedings are the plaintiff and the defendant. Number 4. Ex parte application is another type of civil case. So guys, here the correct answer is number 2, which says action proceeding is used when there are no fundamental disputes on the facts of the case between the parties involved. Question 11. Indicate the correct statement. Headnotes and catchphrases start with the word held, which indicate the finding of the court and are not important when reading a court case. Number 2. Headnotes are compiled by the publishers of the law reports. Number 3, heads of argument refers to the persuasive legal argument made by legal representatives of the parties involved in dispute, and it is backed up by relevant legal sources. Number 4, head notes contain the summary of the case the editors considered less important. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says heads of argument refers to the persuasive legal argument made by legal representatives of the parties involved in dispute, and it is backed up by relevant legal sources. Question 12. Indicate the correct statement. Number 1. Order is to cost are all expenses of the case incurred by the parties, legal representatives, and the presiding officer. Number 2, court rules do not stipulate the amount of legal costs that a party or parties in dispute could be ordered to pay at the end of the case. Number 3, there are no orders as to cost in criminal cases, only in civil cases. Number 4, orders as to cost are the expenses involved in case and are given at the beginning of the case. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says there are no orders as to cost in criminal cases, only in civil cases. Question 18. Indicate the incorrect statement. Mostly a judgment takes the following form. Number 1. First, the facts of the case are given. Number 2. Second, discussion of the relevant legal principles. Number 3, third application of the law to the facts of cases. Number 4, fourth in order is given. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which says fourth in order is given. Question 14. Indicate the correct answer. Your client Hlompho Kikana has purchased a red VW Golf GTI for 360,000 baht inclusive. What was the price of the VW Golf before VAT was added? Calculate VAT at 15%. So guys, in order to get the amount here, what you have to do is to, let me write it down for you so that you understand. You have to say 1,100 divided by 115 times this amount which is 360,000 times 360,000. So let's calculate this, guys, and see what we'll get. So 100 divided by 115 times 360. Let me see. Okay, guys, the correct answer is 318,043.47. Which is option 2. So let me highlight it for you guys. Okay guys, let's go to question number 15. Indicate the correct statement. Julima and Dimsif Floyd divided the profit of their business enhanced food factory EFF on a pro rata basis of 1:2:3. Their profit is 600,000. Julima will get what? So guys, what you have to do here first you have to add these ratios together. So let's add the ratios together and see what we will get. Okay guys, 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is 6. Then after getting this amount, you'll have to check the question again and look what the question is asking for. So here they're asking for what? They're asking for Julima. So Julima here is number what? Julima here is number 1. So what you have to do is to say, since Julima is this ratio which is 1, let me highlight it for you, which is 1. You have to say 1 1 divided by 6. 6 is the amount which you got from adding this times this amount which is 600,000. Times 600,000. Then you get your answer. So if you say 1/6 times 600,000, the answer is 100,000. So which is option 3 is the correct answer. Question 16. It is uneconomical to repair Trili Mobohaya's red Isuzu Becky then after it was involved in a road accident fund collision. However, he is entitled to claim 775,000 from the pre-accident value of the motor vehicle, which was estimated at 84,000. How much is the salvage value for the wreck? So guys, here what you have to do is to take this amount, which is the amount which was estimated. So what you have to do is to take this amount which is 84,000. 84,000, so let's do the calculations. 84,000 84,000, you have to subtract from this 84,000 minus 75,000. Then you get your answer. Minus 75,000. So, the correct answer here, let me calculate and see what I will get. 84,000 minus 75,000. Let's see. Also, guys, the correct answer is number 2, which is 9,000. So, it means option 2 is correct. Question number 17. Indicate the correct statement. The purpose of the SCR 1501 module is to number 1. Make law students excel in the theory of law. Number 2. Let students do most of the work. Number 3. Enable students to develop skills relevant to legal studies. Number 4. Evaluate the Law Society of South Africa and the General Bar Council of Advocates. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says enable students to develop skills relevant to legal studies. Question 18. Indicate the incorrect statement. The following are characteristics of the concept law. Number 1. Law is a system of rules. Number 2. Law applies to human beings. Number 3. Law applies the force of gravity to peace and order in the society. Number 4. The state recognizes rules in order for them to become law. SCL 1501 or 101. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says law applies the force of gravity to peace and order in the society. Question 19. Indicate the incorrect statement. Law is always enforced by the state in the society it operates. Number 1. The statement is true. Number 2. This statement is false. Number 3. This statement is true only in the relation to constitutional law. Number 4. This statement is true only in the relation to civil law. So guys, here the correct answer is number 1, which says this statement is true. Question number 20. Indicate the correct answer. A learning style through which a skill is acquired when a student learns through experiences is called number 1. Skills learning development. Number 2. Subjective B. Number 3. Study process. Number 4. Learning by doing. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4. It says learning by doing. Question number 21. Indicate the correct statement. Which of the following are not duties of paralegals? Number 1. Conducting legal research. Number 2. Organizing evidence to the presented at trial. Number 3, statement B with appropriate supervision by a lawyer. Number 4, statement A and B with appropriate supervision by a lawyer. So guys, here the correct answer is number 2, which is organizing evidence to be presented at trial. Question 22. Indicate the incorrect statement. An advocate carries out the following duties. Number 1, legal opinion. Number 2, litigation. Number 3, draft legal documents. Number 4, give brief to attorneys. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, says give briefs to attorneys. Question 23. Indicate the correct statement. Which of the following would indicate if a court is hearing a criminal or civil matter? Number 1, the presence or absence of a police officer. Number 2, whether the parties had legal representation. Number 3, standard of proof is required. Number 4, whether the case is heard in the higher court. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is the standard of proof is required. Question 24. Indicate the correct statement. Which of the institutions fall under Chapter 9 of the Constitution of the Republic of South Africa? Number 1, the National Prosecuting Authority. Number 2, the University of South Africa. Number 3, the Department of Justice. Number 4, the South African Human Rights Commission. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which is the South African Human Rights Commission. Question 25. Indicate the correct answer. When a court establishes a binding precedent, the reason for its decision in Latin is referred to as number 1, obiter, number 2, res judicata, number 3, ratio resident, number 4, postia. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is ratio resident. Question number 26. Indicate the correct answer. Which of the following courts will never be the court of first instance? Number 1, the High Court. Number 2, the Magistrate Court of Appeal. Number 3, the Supreme Court of Appeal. Number 4, the Constitutional Court. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is the Supreme Court of Appeal. Question 27. Indicate the correct statement. If a case goes on appeal and the appellant wins, we would say? So guys, sorry for the spelling here. It's if a case, not casa. If a case goes on appeal and the appellant wins, we would say? Number 1, the appeal was dismissed and the decision upheld. Number 2, the appeal was dismissed and the decision reversed. Number 3, the appeal succeeds and decision upheld. Number 4, the appeal succeeds and the decision reversed. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which is the appeal succeeds and the decision reversed. Question number 28. The trial state before the cross-examination is referred to as number 1, main examination, number 2, first cross-examination, number 3, examination in shape, number 4, re-examination. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is examination in shape. Question 29. Indicate the incorrect statement. The following characterizes a student as a subjective being. Number 1, interaction and dialogue with your teacher or lecturer. Number 2, engaging and questioning current affairs. Number 3, memorization and regurgitation. Number 4, research on the subject matter. So guys, the correct answer is number 3, which is memorizing and regurgitation. Question 30. Indicate incorrect statement. The act has to undergo the following process in order to be effective. Number 1, passed by the Parliament. Number 2, signed by the President. Number 3, published in the Government Gazette. Number 4, signed by the Minister. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which is signed by the Minister. Question 31. Indicate the correct statement. Argumentum ad hominem is number 1, is allowed during cross-examination. Number 2, is a form of irrelevance in arguments. Number 3, is irrelevant only in criminal cases. Number 4, is irrelevant at any stage of the trial. So guys, here the correct answer is number 2, which is a form of irrelevance in arguments. Question 32. Indicate the correct statement. The following statement are of use for meaningful education. Number 1, learning is a core element of banking education. Number 2, interrogation of the curriculum. Number 4, praxis forms part of banking education. Number 4, Paul Ferre supports banking education. So guys, here the correct answer is number 2, says interrogation of the curriculum. Question number 33. Indicate the correct statement. The legal profession is regulated by the following. Number 1, the judicial. Number 2, the Attorneys Act 53 of 1979. Number 3, the State Attorneys Act 58 of 1957. Number 4, the Legal Practice Act 28 of 2014. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which is the Legal Practice Act 28 of 2014. Question 34. Indicate the correct statement. An effective communicator does the following. Number 1. Uses 65 for non-verbal communication. Number 2. Uses 35 for verbal communication. Number 3. Listens while noting the other person's feelings. Number 4. Tries to remain subjective at all times. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is listens while it's not in the other person's reading. Question 35. Indicate the correct statement. The main object of cross-examination is to, number 1, discredit the witness's statement. Number 2, objective of the statement of the other side. Number 3, punch holes in the evidence of the judge. Number 4, make the lawyer protect his or her client. So guys, here the correct answer is number 1, which is discredit the witness's statement. Question 36. Indicate the correct statement. If the president signs an isiZulu version of an act of parliament, it means number 1, the act will be effective in the KwaZulu-Natal province. Number 2, the act will be effective after it has been translated to English. Number 3, the isiZulu interpretation will prevail over the other version of the act. Number 4, all courts must have an isiZulu interpreter. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is the isiZulu interpretation will prevail over the other version of the act. Question 37. Indicate the correct statement. Presumptions are necessary when reading or interpreting legislation because, number 1, the Constitution requires them to be supreme law of the land. Number 2, they are contained in the Interpretation Act 38 of 1957. Number 3, they are applied retrospectively. Number 4, they give guidance where acts are silenced or vaga on an issue. So here guys, the correct answer is number 4, which says they give guidance where acts are silent or vague on an issue. Question 38. Indicate the correct statement. Number 1. The procedure in action proceedings is stated by way of a noting of a notice of motion. Number 2. Action proceeding is used when there are no fundamental disputes on the facts the cases between the parties involved. Number 3. The parties in action proceedings are the majority, minority, and separate. Number 4. The ex parte application is another type of civil cases. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which is the ex parte application is another type of civil cases. Question 39. Indicate the correct statement. Number 1. Head notes and catch phrase are written by the judges. Number 2. Head notes are compiled by the publishers of the Government Gazette. Number 3. Head notes contain the summary of the case. Number 4. Head notes forms the basis of head argument. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says head notes contains the summary of the case. Question 40. Indicate the correct statement. Order as to cost are instructions from the court order. Number 2. Order as to cost forms part of the examination in chief. Number 3. There are no orders as to cost in criminal cases, only in the civil cases. Number 4. Orders as to cost is normally stated at the end of an act of parliament. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says there are no orders as to cost in criminal cases, only in civil cases. Question 41. Indicate the correct statement. In a case, more than one judge is given when number 1. The judgment represents the opinion of all judges. Number 2. The court acquire is a high court. Number 3. The law is applied to the facts of the case. Number 4. When there is no agreement among the judges. So guys, here the correct answer is number 4, which is when there is no agreement among the judges. Question 42. Indicate the correct statement. Number 1. Minority decision binds the smaller court. Number 2. Separate judgment binds only the small claims court. Number 3. A majority judgment carries hair ratio deterrent. Number 4. A minority judgment applies to minor cases. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which is a majority judgment carries the ratio of evidence. Question number 43. Indicate the correct statement. The ratio of deterrent in a case indicates the following. Number 1. Case of major crimes. Number 2. The head note and catchphrase of the case. Number 3. The reason for decision on the court. Number 4. The reasons of the attorneys and advocate. So guys, here the correct answer is number 3, which says the reasons for decision on the court. Question 44. Indicate the correct statement. Your client Judas Chinese Express Mosei Yamedi has purchased a gray VW Polo 1:6 for 260,000 baht inclusive. What was the price of the VW Polo before VAT was added? So guys, here you have to let me calculate, let me write it down for you guys. Here what you have to do is to say 100 die Wahl gewonnen hat. Times this amount, which is 260,000 times 2, times 2, then what is the amount? So let me calculate for you. 100 divided by 115 times 260,000. So guys, the correct answer is option 4, which is 222,086.95. So the answer is 226,086.95 cents. This is option number 4. Okay, guys, let's go to our last questions. Question 45. Please, guys, do subscribe to this channel for more videos. So, question number 45, indicate the correct statement. Number 1, inexperienced advocates and attorneys may represent parties in small claims courts. Number 2, magistrates are private legal practitioners and therefore are independent. Number 3, presiding officers in higher courts are called judges. Number 4, the parties in criminal cases are the plaintiff and the defendant. So guys, the correct answer is number 3, which says presiding officers in high courts are called judges. So guys, good luck with your studies.